Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. This, in my humble opinion, is one of the finest stealth games ever made, and it is personally an honor of mine to be covering this for my channel. Now, one of the things that I want to show you guys is the fact that if you go into the sound settings here, you have an option called Use Native Languages. I have turned it to on for this playthrough. I'll switch it to off for the first person perspective playthrough, which is gonna come after this playthrough is done. Anyhow, I like to keep it this way. It makes the game just a little more immersive, even though you can't understand what the NPCs are saying unless you grab and interrogate them, which is something that we will be trying to do very less in this playthrough. I basically want to keep it as pure as possible and not touch a single soul unless absolutely necessary, which is surprisingly easy to do in this version. So yeah, let's make a new game. We will keep it at normal. I mean, at expert it would be a challenge, but let's just keep it at normal.
Looks like a Chinese Jiangwei class cruiser with a North Korean destroyer escort. Events in the Yellow Sea took a turn for the worse today when North Korean and Chinese forces blockaded and boarded a Japanese cargo ship. The North Korean government released no official statement, and their ambassador remained out of contact. While at the UN, Chinese Ambassador Long Dan urged the US and her longtime Japanese allies to remain calm, calling the blockades a legitimate response to what the rest of Asia views as a possible remilitarization of Japan.
This blockade is an act of war. The NSC is working on a formal response, and they've ordered the USS Walsh to close at flank speed. The Walsh is the most advanced spy ship in history. My best man will be on board. What do you know? Chinese and North Korean ships working together again.
It's what we expected.
That's a 056 prototype, Chinese.
Exactly.
How are your sea legs?
I haven't lost them.
Good. Because the 056 prototype isn't the only new fish in the pond.
Admiral Toshiro Otomo, head of Japan's newly formed Information Self-Defense Force, had this to say.
This is another distressing attempt by China and North Korea to further depress our faltering economy. The ISDF and Japan appeal to our allies for the military support promised us under the post-war constitution of 1946.
The fact remains that in the eyes of many in Asia, the ISDF itself is a violation of the post-war constitution, prohibiting Japan from maintaining a military force capable of striking beyond its borders. In Asia, the memories of Imperial Japan are still fresh.
Senator.
That's right. It has been a while.
Nice condom you got here.
Well, thanks. I got a space set up for you in the forecastle. You can make yourself your home and no one will even know you're here.
Punta Blanco Lighthouse outside Talara, Peru. I'm hoping that's how you pronounce those names. Bruce Morgenholt has been kidnapped by a Peruvian specialist group known as the People's Voice. Morgenholt's knowledge of dangerous computer algorithms must not fall into the hands of the People's Voice or their leader, Hugo Lacerda. Now, here's the thing. The cutscenes seem to be a little inconsistent. Lambert asks Fisher how his sea legs are, but Fisher is... I assumed Fisher was going aboard a ship, but he's going to a lighthouse. I suppose this is where we get the information of where the ship is. So, full disclosure, I have completed this game multiple times before. And, yeah, it's just a pleasure to do it again, just for this channel. It's a pleasure to play this game anytime.
Fisher, an American engineer named Bruce Morgenholt, has been kidnapped by a Peruvian separatist group called the People's Voice. Their suspected leader, Hugo Lacerda, is a hardcore revolutionary preaching information warfare as the only realistic means to achieve revolution in modern society. We need you to get in there and recover or destroy any information Morgenholt may have been forced to divulge, and if possible, rescue him. As for Lacerda, he's just been bumped onto our target of opportunity list. So if you have a shot, take it.
Hostage rescue isn't normally our bag, but Morgenholt was part of Project Watson, the UN committee that studied Phillip Masse's handiwork after Georgia. Some people are worried that this kidnapping is just a cover-up, and that Morgenholt is being interrogated for classified information about the Masse Kernels. Fact is that some of the tricks Masse came up with could be used to do a lot of damage. We need to contain that information at all costs.
The target area is a lighthouse attached to an abandoned Spanish colonial-era fortification and some nearby structures. We don't have an exact location on Morgenholt, so you'll have to find him yourself. Insertion will be at night by Zodiac onto the beach beneath the fort. Thermal imaging shows that there are some old natural and semi-natural caves under the fort, so you may be able to use those for infiltration.
All right, Fisher. The helicopter will drop you a few kilometers offshore in the Zodiac. You'll have one of my Zodiacs and logistical support in and out of the target area. Extraction will be by helicopter from the top of the lighthouse.
This place international holds the contract with Wright Pritchard Technologies to protect their VIPs in potentially hostile situations. We did a thorough threat evaluation for their project in Peru, and we accepted the VIP detail on Morgenholt. The guys who came after him knew what they were doing. This was not a tourist grab. I lost 3 good men in the snatch, and I'm currently preparing a rescue plan for approval from Morgenholt's family and Wright Pritchard. This is going to cost this place a lot of money.
Yeah, so one of the features that I like about this game is how you don't have to read through all of that, but at the same time, unless you're paying attention to what they're saying, it's easy to get lost and just, well, forget about whatever they're saying, essentially. Now, one of the things
hostage rescue that isn't normally our bag, but
Anna
Morgenholt was part
said
of Project
here,
Watson,
can I, like,
the UN committee that studied Phillip
yeah,
Masse's
I can't,
handiwork after
speak,
Georgia.
Like, I have to
some people are worried
let
that
her finish.
Kidnapping.
Let that be. I'll just go to the loadout page, but yeah. So Anna says that hostage rescue isn't exactly a forte. Now, that makes up we've never really rescued a hostage in any of the past Splinter Cell games, but we have kidnapped people quite a few times. I remember that kidnapping Tilbury, so I don't think this is going to be too difficult either. Now, at this point, it really doesn't matter what loadout you take, because we are not planning to use any of this. All we need is just a pistol and us, and that's it. But just for the sake of, you know, gameplay, I'll take the stealth loadout. So this level is one of the more smoother ones. And just look at Sam there. Love the way the camera slips and slides all over the place. This game is perfection. That is where we need to go. Up here. And you don't even need to press Q if you're moving towards a narrow space. Sam will do it automatically. Put his back to the wall, I mean.
hearing gunfire down there, Fisher. Everything all right?
It's coming from up ahead, but Lambert, when I think guerrilla, I think Kalashnikov.
What do you mean?
I've had enough AKs fired at me in my time to tell you that wasn't one.
All right. See if there's anything unusual going on with their equipment. And keep us posted.
Yeah, so this game is also... divided into like multiple sections. Like, you have lots of objectives in the level that you can choose. A few of them are primary and the rest are just objectives that you can choose to accomplish. So you guys might want to hear what they're saying, but thing is, well, they're speaking Spanish, so unless you understand Spanish, it's a moot point. So this is one of the ways you can infiltrate this area. And we can also use our OCR to scan stuff.
I think you're right about the equipment, Sam.
Yeah. They got themselves a little stockpile of high-tech kit here.
The SSCC code is lot 1 of 5. See if you can find the other 4.
I'll do my best.
Roger Lambert. Now, there's a reason that things might be appearing a little too bright to you guys, and that's because, this game is currently rendering in HDR, which is an option that they gave back in, like, 2007 of all times. So right now I'm just waiting for this card to essentially move towards, you know, go there and set up his targets, but I don't think he will actually do that right now. So let's just move on to this section here. Yeah, he's gonna empty his mag now and then he's gonna go check. Until he does, we're here. Could have played that a little smoother, but oh well. We did save there. Up ahead, I mean. We are hidden, quite hidden shadows right here, so not really a problem to remain here either. Or here for that matter. Doesn't look like it though, does it? I mean, the HDR rendering of this game is sort of off, if you ask me. There are also like plenty of other kinds of vision that you can use for this game, including stuff like night vision, heat vision, electricity vision, and more. But yeah. The thing is, I forgot how this level goes. I think this guy will move over to the right. On cue. We have already tagged that, no need to tag it again.
¿No crees que ya es suficiente?
Será suficiente cuando deje de hablar.
Santo cielo, pero si hace más de una hora que no puede hablar.
¿Y si está fingiendo?
¡No!
I am Batman.
Jesús.
Sí, está fingiendo.
¿Fingiendo? Tiene la lengua carbonizada. ¿Y el cerebro?
Basta. Dale más corriente, Saúl.
So you guys can see him, see them torturing somebody here.
¿Quieres que traiga otra batería?
Qué gracioso el tío.
I'm waiting for them to finish speaking. Oye, as if I can understand whatever they're saying.
Está... Le sale humo de las orejas.
Voy a vomitar. Creo que está muerto.
Solo hay una forma de estar seguros. Me voy a dar un paseo.
So just for the record, Morgenholt is already dead, and even if you assault them right now, you will not be able to save Morgenholt. So yeah, no matter what we do, we cannot save Morgenholt at this point, he is already dead. But what I like to do is save him when I can. Like cut him down. I'm just waiting for that guy to go in, and we should be free to go.
Stinks.
What I don't
understand. It doesn't sound too good down there, Fisher.
The sound isn't the problem. You should smell it.
You're sure he's dead?
Deader than Elvis.
All right. Leave the body. We still need to recover any traces of the interrogation. Grim, we'll call you back. Fisher, I said leave the body. We don't have the means to extract him.
Just because he's dead doesn't mean I need to leave him here hanging like a piece of meat.
Don't get too connected, Fisher. I need you to stay rational.
You can spare 30 seconds for some simple dignity.
That is true. That is in fact true.
Sam, it's Grim. We need to make sure that whatever Morgenholt might have told them about Masse's algorithms never leaves this site.
Okay.
I detected a wireless link coming from the technician who left the room before you entered.
So I'll need to recover any data he might have uploaded to their servers.
Exactly.
Right then. Let's pick this lock. Yeah, I always dislike how, even though the first button might be the grid button, this in the PC version of Splinter Cell, it is not accepted. Oh yeah, I need to close the doors as well in this game. I tend to forget from time to time.
From the looks of it, these gorillas have a pretty temporary setup. Seems unlikely they have any kind of alarm system on location.
Good.
Good is good. So where is this damn crate that I missed? Should be it's over there, right in that tent. Aren't you two gonna like chat or something?
Ahora ya se puede bajar.
Pues entonces baja.
Es tu turno. Te toca a ti hacer la patrulla.
No es cuestión de turno, sino de antigüedad.
¿Antigüedad? ¿Qué te crees que es esto? ¿Un ministerio?
Auto. Pero cuando lleguemos al gobierno, crearemos un cuerpo de funcionarios, así que mejor ponte de mi parte.
I mean, there are two ways here. We could have taken that tour as well, which we will be taking when I take the assault route. Or we can climb up here. And we can still go down there, by the way, if we want to. One of the things about I'm curious about in this game is whether the music from whether the music from the radios will get me a copyright strike. I'm quite curious to know, actually. Yeah, so let's stick to the wall and go as far as ahead as we can. Maybe it'll help us stay more hidden. I do not know. Only one way to find out, though.
¿Has zarpado sin problemas el barco?
Sí, estará fuera un tiempo.
¿Cuántos hombres iban?
La cerda se ha llevado a cuatro más.
¿Podrás mantener la guardia con cuatro hombres menos?
No se nos colará nadie, señor.
I think that confirms it, Fisher.
Yeah, seems like Lacerda's long gone.
We'll see if we can track him through Echelon. Don't worry about him for now. We'll keep you posted.
So that's one of the crates that you can scan. Yeah, so once that guy goes there and starts just essentially standing there, not much you can do apart from two things. One is to just cause a glitch in this thing down here, or two, just cause a glitch in this lamp up here. And I'm going to do the ladder. Recover or destroy the information about the Masse Kernels. That's as simple a request as you get. No But what I'd like to do is
that
just...
server is the one that the tech transferred the interrogation record to. You'll need to access it. Good work, Sam. That wiped whatever information Morgenholt might have given them.
Don't they wonder what happened to it?
It was easy enough to make your little intrusion look like a memory allocation error. Don't worry, we give you the best tools.
So yeah, I got to it before this guy started looking at it, and... So here's the funny thing, if you don't get to the laptop quick enough, this guy's just gonna stand in front of the laptop and waste the rest of his day there. But if you manage to get to the laptop while he's not looking, you essentially no longer have to worry about him. You can, like, read stuff on the laptop at your own leisure. So, like, for example, People's Voice suspected in Morgenholt. Newswire to subscriber. People's Voice suspected in Morgenholt kidnapping, which is true. I wonder about how the news organization has that news. The thing is, when you're on the laptop in this game, stuff around you does not pause, or even on the op side for that matter. The Peruvian government has communicated their suspicions that American Bruce Morgenholt was kidnapped by an organization known as the People's Voice. The group itself has not released any public statements, and contact with the ISS is lost. Contact with the International Space Station has been lost. Technicians fear the station may have been struck by a micrometeor. Oh damn. EP. I wonder what that is. Sounds, suggestive. Hey Jimbo, so I took Pietro up on his offer and came camping with his buddies. Turns out they're a bunch of half-organized revolutionaries. Kinda harmless though. Anyway, I was looking around in some caves here and spotted some bioluminescent fungus. Or maybe it was fungus that was host to Photobacterium phosphorum. Not sure. I'll try and get you a sample. So it was basically the green glowing bacteria that we saw near the beginning of this level that they're talking about right there. Oh, so one more thing. You don't really need to go all the way there and physically access most of the stuff. You can just use your offset to do that. And, yeah. You can just use your offset to, access the stuff. Not your offset. I don't know what these are, the special Binox that you have. No, it's not.
No los vimos y tampoco llegamos a oírlos. Sincronizaban sus disparos con los truenos.
It's strange. It works sometimes and it does not work out at other times. Difficult to tell when it will work out and when it won't. But anyway, there should be a crate right there, and I just want to scan it quickly.
That's 4 of the 5 crates, Sam. Your eyes peeled for the last one.
I believe it's somewhere up ahead. And that's the way to the rappelling part of the game. If you want to go rappelling, that's how you go. Anyhow, since we cleared the section without any issues... I do believe the last crate is in the lighthouse up ahead, but I'm not certain yet. This generally dark game looks so much brighter in HDR. You can see a guy just strolling over there, and if this game was not in HDR, I would not have seen this outline there. And that guy's there. I had to reload this because I sort of bumped into that guy. I mean, I was just waiting there and this guy sort of walked into me. So, yeah. Just waiting for this guy to go away as well. I mean, as is typical in a stealth game, you do have to wait around a lot, even in this game, for the perfect opportunity to present itself before you can get a move on. Apparently this guy is gonna look on both sides before he goes back. And here is where I save. Are you not satisfied yet? Strange, I don't recall this behavior from him. I really do hope that he does not stop moving again. That was close. that was close. I'm betting he's gonna return back this way. Crawling circles around the guy, huh? That's what this game is all about.
Maria Narcissa.
You're not trying to set me up on another blind date, I hope.
The Maria Narcissa is a boat.
So was the last girl you set me up with.
Fisher.
Sorry.
The Maria Narcissa is a cargo ship owned and operated by Celestina Inc., Portuguese shipping company. Registered in the Philippines, cross-Pacific freight contracts. Lots of details missing.
Sounds suspicious.
Sounds like I'm setting you up for another date after all.
Can't wait to meet her.
Fisher, your primary objectives are complete. We can extract you whenever you're ready. You'll need to signal for a helicopter pickup from the top of the lighthouse. Make sure the light is out first.
Will do.
Now, I do believe I have perhaps missed one of those crates. Unless it is up there, somewhere up top. So if you killed that guy at the bottom, you can basically figure out where Lacerda is headed by rummaging through this cabinet. You can get the option now because you have already completed that, and in case you get into firefights, which this game allows you to do by the way, suppose it in fact, you can just use this medkit to heal yourself. Now you can go slow or you can go fast, but there's this one step that is going to make a sound up ahead. Maybe I have missed a crate. It's been a while since I forgot this stuff is in this game. I'm not gonna bother too much with it though. It would seem I have missed a crate. Now where could the crate be? Since we've come all this way, I'm really not gonna bother with it. Although I do want to try getting everything in this game, but I guess I missed one of the locations where the crate actually could be. The next section is pretty much it. One of the only difficult parts to this level, and yeah, let's just climb. So that guy there, you just want to make sure that that guy does not see you. That is not what I wanted to do. Let me just you need to switch off the lighthouse, light on top of the lighthouse, and well, let me just go ahead and equip this, bring out the sticky shocker, and aim for that guy. That's all you need to do, and yeah, you're free to call for extraction now. Now, I think I did miss a crate somewhere. One was down there. Yeah, I guess I must have missed a crate somewhere. Strange. I don't recall where though. One was at the bottom, one was, you know, just above it at the stairs. One was somewhere near. Oh yeah, one was perhaps inside the tent that we did not pierce through. So there's like a tent that we can pierce through, and I guess we forgot to pierce through that tent. Let me call for extraction now and then just add it in later to show you guys where it is. Yeah, this is what I want to complete, and yeah, let me just go ahead and retry it. Huh. And Rescue Morgenholt was cancelled. Alright, statistics. 9 minutes and 17 seconds. Pretty sure the speedrunners can do it much quicker. I mean, they do have lots of tricks up their sleeves, so I guess that's that. So yeah, that was that for this mission. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. We came here to kill Hugo Lacerda and to rescue Morgenholt, but as is apparent, both of our objectives have been cancelled. Lacerda has already left the island, and Morgenholt has sadly passed away. But we did destroy all information that Morgenholt might have given them about the Masse Kernels, and we also figured out where the guerrillas got their arms and equipment. That is some that is it leads to this ship on the seas called Maria Narcisa is what it's called. And of course we did reach the primary extraction point. That is how we completed this level. Could not have done it without that. The SSCC barcode of the delivered crates, it helps us figure out where they basically got the ammunition from. And in addition to all of this, this game also has like a few opportunity I won't call them opportunity objectives, I will call them like hidden secondary objectives which the game doesn't really activate unless and until you essentially complete the first objective on your own. So yeah, we'll get to those in upcoming levels, but yeah, that's how this game works. Anyhow, this was this for Mission Lighthouse. When we come back, we will be trailing Hugo Lacerda onto the ship that was hijacked at the very beginning of the opening cutscene. And yeah, we'll be trying to catch him in the act there. Well, basically trying to bring him to justice once there. Until then, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Farewell, fellow Earthlings. Take care. Sort of messed up the outro there.